The rock found below the surface of this southern isle is arguably more famous across the world than the beauty of the rugged scenery above. So, where am I and what lies beneath? I'll tell you in just a moment.
Today I'm with a couple who are setting up in suburbia in search of a better quality of life in the countryside.
I'm struggling to think of something in this room that I'm not in love with.
Ooh.
Yeah.
And with time of the essence, they're not messing about.
Wow.
Seriously, get your checkbook out now.
Today I'm in Dorset and this is the Isle of Portland at the southernmost point of the county. Now the island's unique limestone bedrock, known as Portland Stone, was first quarried back in Roman times, but has since been used to construct some of the world's most iconic buildings, from St Paul's Cathedral in London to the United Nations headquarters in New York. Now, later on, I'll be back on Portland, getting up close and personal and experiencing this world-famous stone. But first, let's take a look at what else this wonderful county has to offer.
The county of Dorset lies in the southwest of England, with the English Channel lying off its southern shore. Known as the Jurassic Coast, the 95 miles of rugged coastline layers of sedimentary rock reveal 185 million years of the Earth's history. At the Dorset-Devon border sits the port town of Lyme Regis. Nicknamed the Pearl of Dorset, it's a popular starting point for sailing, diving and fossil-finding trips, its cliffs crumbling into the Jurassic seas. Further along the Dorset coast, in a sheltered bay, Georgian houses line the beachfront at the seaside town of Weymouth. The golden sands and shallow waters here make it an ideal spot for families seeking a traditional seaside getaway. And it was a favourite of King George III, who holidayed here for nearly 15 years at the turn of the 19th century. Those more interested in history than beach life might prefer to visit the romantic ruins of Corfe Castle. Standing over a gap in the Purbeck Hills, the former royal palace and fortress was built in the 11th century by William the Conqueror. So, with a mix of dramatic coastline and picturesque towns and villages, an unspoiled countryside with not a motorway in sight, Dorset really is the perfect place for those looking for a countryside escape.
Well, there are no two ways about it. Buying here in Dorset comes with a hefty price tag. The average cost of a detached home here is around £357,000. Now that's about £57,000 above the national figure. Buyers, it seems, are willing to pay a premium for the beauty of Dorset's stunning coastline and countryside, a landscape that has been the inspiration to some of our greatest authors, from Thomas Hardy to Jane Austen. So as one of today's buyers is a would-be writer, they're certainly going to find themselves in good company.
2 years ago, Chris and Kate bought their first home as a couple, a four-bedroom semi in Reigate, Surrey. But their adventure together started long before.
We first met through mutual friends when Kate was at university in Birmingham.
He was a very slow mover in terms of making his move. So 10 years after we met, I think he finally plucked up the courage to ask me out.
10 years of groundwork.
Yeah.
Chris grew up in close proximity to the countryside in North Wales and Cheshire, whilst Kate, born and bred in Reigate, is used to more suburban surroundings.
When I grew up here, it was a lovely, sort of very community-driven sort of town. And I think over the last 30 years, more and more people have moved here who commute into London. So it's sort of lost its sense of community. And it's incredibly busy, it's got bigger.
Not too far from Kate's family and friends in Surrey, they've decided Dorset is the perfect place for them to set up home. And although Kate is looking to slow things down, Chris will be taking his fast-paced job with him.
So I'm a paramedic. I've been in the ambulance service for about 7 years now. you know, it can certainly be a challenging job, but, you know, it's very rewarding at the same time. I originally started working for London, so, you know, driving around the big cities and, you know, lots of traffic and people everywhere. And then the move out to Surrey was a big change already. So I think the move to Dorset won't be quite as big a shock. You know, it's certainly, you have to be more wary of, you know, other road users in terms of like horses, foxes, yeah, badgers, I don't know.
Kate's hoping that the change of scenery will also offer inspiration for her hobby.
I'm a sort of secret writer. I've always wanted to be a writer, and then I don't really have a lot of confidence in it. So for me, this gives me an opportunity to hopefully be able to carve out some time for me to write in a sort of quiet and peaceful environment.
With their house on the market and Chris's new job due to start in just 6 weeks, they're well on their way to making the big move. Although they'll be leaving Kate's family behind, their pet Labrador, Dolly, will definitely be coming with them.
I think a lot of this move is also about Dolly. So we want to be somewhere where we can fling the door open and go straight out into the countryside, or, you know, hopefully for me, near the seaside. So I'd love to just be able to jump in the car and be 5 minutes away from the beach and just be able to walk her there in the mornings. That would be amazing.
As Chris's job will be based in Dorset, we're keeping our search within the county borders. Ideally, he and Kate would like to be near the sea, but they're happy to look anywhere. I'm catching up with them to find out exactly what's on their property wish list.
Well, Chris and Kate, here we are in a very sunny Dorset today. But why did you decide this was the part of the country that you wanted to move to?
I was very keen to live by the coast. I always have been. And I think when we started to look at the south coast, this was perhaps more affordable than a lot of the counties towards the east of here. So we're hoping to get a bit more for our money here.
Let's talk about the actual property itself. What are you after?
We're really flexible about it, actually. I mean, there's only the two of us and our dog, so we're happy to look at anything from two bedrooms upwards. I'd like an area to be able to work in, but I'm just as happy if that's a summer house in the garden. But parking is quite an important one, because Chris obviously does shift work as a paramedic, and so we really don't want him having to park two or three roads away if it's 2 o'clock in the morning. So that's sort of a key want for us, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
That makes sense. Chris, what are you looking for then with this home?
I'm even more flexible, really. If I can have a wood burner, I'd be happy. So
a little bit of a garden for the dog, not too big?
Yeah, just somewhere that she can go out.
What does your new home actually look like? What's its style?
I like something with a bit of character. If it's sort of quirky or unusual, I'm going to be really interested at conversion.
Yeah, like a conversion.
Absolutely, I would love that.
How important is it for you two to be close to neighbours and have a community next to you, or is the idea that actually you want to be a little bit more remote?
We'd like to be close to other people, really. Again, particularly because I work shifts.
Yeah. You could
also makes it a bit easier to meet people if you're in a smaller community or in a town. And I think that's one of the things we're really keen to make sure we do straight away.
Yes. So let's remind ourselves of your top budget and ideally what you want to spend.
Top budget would be £350,000. Yeah.
And ideally?
However, I think we'd prefer to stay around 325 if we can. It just gives us a bit more flexibility.
Have a little bit left over.
Absolutely.
Well, I think we should get a move on. Jump in the car because we have some fantastic properties to show you.
Brilliant.
So, shall we?
Thank
yes.
you.
Chris and Kate are hoping their budget of £350,000 will buy them their perfect home in an area of the country they love. They like the idea of a quirky character property, but one which has enough head height for all 6'6" of Chris. They would need two or more bedrooms, a garden for Dolly the dog, and space for Chris to park outside. They'd also prefer to be in a village setting where they can meet other locals. I'll be taking them to see the best properties Dorset has to offer for their budget. But before I reveal the price of each, I'll be asking them to take a guess first. Our final stop will be our mystery house, a property steeped in history and overflowing with character, which I'm hoping will really inspire them. Our first property is in the village of Cattistock in West Dorset. A character village with a lively, active community, it has a village hall attached to the church, a shop, and an award-winning pub. The village also plays host to the famous Dorset Knob Throwing and Froome Valley Food Festival, attracting thousands of visitors every year. The property we're seeing is situated right in the heart of the village.
Well, I'm looking forward to showing you around some of our properties. Let's kick off with this one, our first. It is a chapel.
Indeed. Fabulous. This is, I have a real soft spot for converted chapels, so
do you?
I have to admit I may have looked at this one on the internet, Nikki.
Oh, okay. So that hasn't put you off?
No, we'd be very excited to go in here. And it's a beautiful village.
Yeah. Well, let's step inside and see what you make of our first property.
Fantastic, thank you.
This Methodist chapel was built around 1870 to serve the village. It was sympathetically converted into a home about 20 years ago, retaining some fabulous character features.
Right, let me welcome you to your converted chapel.
Wow.
Lovely.
Very nice.
You do have the character of the chapel, although actually, if you take your eye away from the doors, this just looks like a very pleasant sitting room through a dining room, doesn't it?
It does. You want the character, but you don't want too much character. And so for me, this is actually kind of about the right level. It's really nice.
What about you, Chris?
Love it. it's got the wood burner.
Yeah.
What more do I need?
In the centre of the village.
Exactly.
Yeah. Let's walk through into the kitchen through again. These marvellous doors.
Interesting.
It's like the big reveal going through these door frames. Beautiful.
Very theatrical.
Yeah, very theatrical.
Wow.
Your kitchen. Now, you could class this as a galley kitchen.
Yep.
But
it's quite a wide galley kitchen.
It's generous, isn't it?
I mean, you've got a wonderful range. I love the Belfast sink. It's perfectly big enough for us, isn't it? And
more
if you're entertaining, it's still big enough.
How is this working now? You're actually physically in the house compared to what you saw online.
This seems bigger than... Yeah. We expected the kitchen, certainly.
Well, I'm looking forward to the invite.
Always welcome.
Right, let's keep going.
Well, we're certainly off to a good start with this property. Kate and Chris seem to like the character and the space on offer so far, so I'm pretty confident the upstairs won't disappoint either.
Now, how is this for an unusual feature?
That's fantastic.
The original lamppost and light from the village itself.
Wow, that's a really, really nice feature.
Now, with our chapel, we've actually given you more bedrooms than you asked for. The largest is the master. There's two further single bedrooms, a study and the family bathroom.
Oh, that's fabulous. So I could have a writing room inside the house.
You could. Now, I can't promise you a view, sadly.
No.
But what I can give you is a small dressing room here on top of your wardrobes.
That would be very useful because Chris often goes to work at 4 or 5 in the morning, so if he's not in here getting changed, it would be slightly quieter and I'm more likely to stay asleep if he's in there.
It's like this chapel has been designed for the two
possibly.
Of you. Yeah. Well, let's go outside to look at the space there. Quite an unusual setup. I wonder how much you remember when you looked at those cheeky details online. We'll see. Chris, I'm going to ask you to lead the way. Thank you.
To the side of the property, there's a small south-facing enclosed garden with a decked area accessed from the living room. The property is also being sold with a separate piece of land, which is a 7-minute walk away at the edge of the village. If they wanted, it could provide Kate and Chris with rental income as pasture land. But with its peaceful, elevated position offering views like this, I think they might be tempted to keep it for themselves.
So, unusually, our chapel has this parcel of land. So you come up the bridle path, which is looked after by the farmer, but you've got access into here, and it's nearly 2 acres.
Wow. I think Dolly would enjoy that.
Yes.
So I'm now going to ask you to put a price on this property. But, Kate, how good was your memory when you perused the internet and you saw it?
Now, I can't remember exactly what it was, but I know it came up under our top budget. So I would guess it was maybe about $340.
Right. Chris?
Maybe my memory was a little bit better then. But I seem to remember it being $325.
Wow. Your memory is right. The asking price for the chapel with the nearly 2 acres of land is £325,000.
That's fantastic.
Now, if you wanted to buy the chapel on its own without this land, they would be happy to sell that as well. And the asking price for the chapel on its own is £295,000.
Gosh, that's something to think about.
Yeah, but they have had some serious offers on this land and ideally they want to sell the two together. Do you want to have a little explore on your own?
Yes, please. So. Yes,
quite
please.
A bit, yeah. Go on up there. You get an even better view. I'll hang around and then we can walk back to the village when you're ready.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Off you go.
Coming in well under budget, even with the additional land, this converted chapel has the character features and village location that Kate and Chris were after. There's also 3 bedrooms, a separate study, and outside space for Dolly.
What's up here then? Does it go to this border?
It goes all the way up there.
Yeah.
And you're right up to the top there.
It's not a massive house, but it's got everything that we need, and I love the position right in the middle of the village.
Perhaps upstairs, you know, is a little bit short on head height, but, you know, that's my fault, really, more than anybody else's. But, you know, it's only really upstairs. The downstairs is great.
This plot is amazing, and I think I just would be blown away if I actually owned a piece of land. I think that would be fantastic.
I think that's a good start here in Dorset. Little bit of a walk now, we'll amble back into the village.
Okay.
With its awe-inspiring coastline, rolling chalk hills and river valleys, Dorset is a haven for hikers, ramblers and dog walkers alike. It offers 2,000 miles of footpaths, bridleways and byways to choose from. However, although the windy cliff tops and dense woodlands are attractive for holidaymakers, they also have the potential to be treacherous terrain if you get lost or injured. The Dorset Search Dogs charity was established in 2006 to help rescue missing persons in the area. With Chris's own experience of helping those in need and his and Kate's ambition to explore the Dorset countryside with their dog Dolly, we've arranged for them to meet Chairman Matt Cook to find out more about the charity.
Dorset Search Dogs are set up to find missing people, vulnerable missing people throughout Dorset and neighbouring counties and anybody who wants us, really.
And how does it work then? Who actually calls you out?
We get called out by the police, Coast Guard or neighbouring search and rescue teams. So you can't call us directly, it has to be coordinated by police or Coast Guard.
How often do you find you get called out?
We get called out about 40 to 50 times per year. We're available 24/7. We're all volunteers, so it may not mean that we can attend all the call-outs, but between us we do try and get to as many as we can.
And how do you go about training the dogs?
Well, we've got two of our guys here with two of their dogs. You can go and have a look if you want.
Great. Yeah.
On average, it takes between 12 and 18 months to train a search dog. For the dogs, it's like a big game of hide and seek, starting off with a squeaky toy used as a reward.
This is Wendy with her search dog, Hattie.
Hello.
Hattie's a trainee search dog at the moment. But what we do is we wind the dogs up with a squeaky toy, run off behind like the nearest tree, nearest bush, and then dog goes in. Wendy, if you want to give me your search toy, this is where Hattie will start getting wound up.
Successful search dogs need to have a high play drive and be agile with plenty of stamina. Although any dog could be trained as a search dog, they tend to be larger working breeds like Hattie, who's a giant schnauzer. There are also Springer Spaniels, Labradors and Border Collies in the team. The charity has a number of volunteers who help out on training sessions. Called Dogs Bodies, they play the role of a missing person for the dogs to find.
OK, so we set up a bit of a scenario here. We've got Sue, one of our volunteers. She's sat on a log, felt unwell, fallen over, and she's banged her head. So we wouldn't get that full scenario. All we would get is a call from a relative saying that somebody hasn't turned up. So Steve would go out as a handler with search dog Oscar. Oscar is one of our more experienced dogs. So Steve, show us how it's done.
Are you getting good finds? You're getting good finds. Good finds!
Most search dogs are air scenters, which means rather than tracking a scent like a police dog, they pick up the scent of a human being in the air. With a sense of smell thousands of times stronger than that of a human, some of the Dorset search dogs can detect human scent from 500 to 800 yards away.
Shoving!
Once the dog finds their missing person, they return to the handler to indicate their find.
Hello.
I'm sleeping.
You're okay.
Hello, I'm fine.
What's your name?
Sue.
Sue.
You
alright? Good. This is Matt. He'll sort you out.
Okay. That's the end of the scenario then. Well done.
Now that Chris and Kate have seen the techniques, perhaps they'll be tempted to try out training with Dolly when they make the move. Chris. The house I'm showing them is just under 2 miles from the centre of Bridport in the neighbouring village of Bradpole.
So you said ideally you'd like to be close to the sea. Well, we're about 5-10 minutes away.
Oh, that would be lovely.
Yeah. We try and show our couples sort of different varieties of properties. This one is an old cottage with a thatched porch.
Beautiful.
Really nice.
The good news is the roof is quite new.
Yeah,
that's
fantastic.
That's true. Definitely got some curb appeal, hasn't it?
Hasn't it just?
We are right on the edge of Bridport, so you've got all that community there, lots going on.
That would be nice for me, I think.
Yeah.
They have lots of festivals and things to get involved in.
So, first impressions?
Great roof.
Yeah, I love the little bit of thatch, so
yes,
you've got
I
a bit
do.
Of character.
Yeah.
I'm really looking forward to going in.
Good. On that note, we will. Come
Brilliant.
On.
This property dates back to the 1880s. Originally, it would have been a worker's cottage for the surrounding land. Despite showing its age on the outside, I think the interior might surprise them.
So we all love this delightful porch.
Fantastic.
Could call it a boot room or a little dog room. And it leads us straight into the kitchen diner.
I love it.
Wow.
It's really nice. I'm struggling to think of something in this room that I'm not in love with.
Ooh.
Yeah, it's great.
It's been done really well.
Yeah.
And it's very much our taste as well.
Yeah, very much.
The current owners have had it about 6-7 years.
Yeah. Okay.
They've done all the work on it. They actually live next door.
Ah.
And this is a holiday let.
Ah, okay.
So they've done the whole property, apart from that conservatory at the back, or utility room, in actual fact, it's probably a better word for it. It's got a downstairs cloakroom, basic but functional, a log store, and there's water out there. So if you were ever going to think of a project and perhaps extending slightly, you've already got the footprint.
Yeah.
You need, obviously, to get the right planning permission, but you could extend a little bit further out if you wanted to take this and have a bit more space.
Fantastic.
Well, it sounds like you could both certainly live in this room. Let's see what you make of next door. If I can squeeze past you. Thank you. Right. Reactions for our sitting room, please.
I still love it. Love the wooden floorboards that have been painted white. It's beautifully done out. It's really charming.
How are the ceilings?
Fabulous. I wouldn't even think to notice them, really.
I think from outside I was a wee bit, are we going to have a ceiling-related problem? But actually, it's like a normal-sized house, so I wonder if they might be slightly lower upstairs. But
I like that, a ceiling-related problem. That's good. I'm going to use that one again. Well, let's go upstairs and see if we do have any issues.
Okay.
The upstairs of the property has a family bathroom and 2 bedrooms, a good-sized double for guests and the master bedroom.
So downstairs has been a bit of a success story. I'm hoping this will be the same upstairs.
We should just buy it now. It's fabulous. And I wouldn't have thought outside that the inside would look like this, because I think you get all the character and the age outside, and then something quite modern and stylish inside.
No ceiling issues.
No ceiling issues. So far, it's just perfect for what we were looking for.
Oh, my goodness. I'm so happy. But a small word of caution, because we are quite close to Bridport, and we've got to decide how much it's on the market for. Get too excited.
Don't break our hearts, Nikki.
No, but we're going to head outside and we're going to talk money. So, bring my guest. Off you go.
Internally, this property has a high standard of finish. But outside, the paved back garden is the low-maintenance space you'd expect from a rental property and could benefit from some work. Nonetheless, fully enclosed and with side access, it would make an adequate space for Dolly.
Now, at the moment, it's practical, isn't it? Yeah. But you could put down a little bit of lawn here and you're going to get the sun, not in the evenings, but certainly during the day. Again, just somewhere for the dog.
Absolutely. Mm. Yeah, I mean, this is workable because there's no doubt plenty of walks on the doorstep because we're in that part of the country, so...
The tour of the cottage has gone exceedingly well.
Yep.
Final part, obviously, is to try and put a price on it.
I think I would say this is on for £320.
I'm going to say a little bit higher. I'm going to say 335.
OK. I'm going to give you two completely different figure to either of those.
OK.
Asking price, £275,000.
Wow.
Seriously, get your chequebook out now. Fabulous. Thank you for showing it to us. It's wonderful.
So I am guessing on your own this time you'd like to take a second look.
Yes, please.
Off you go. Thank you. It is a wonderful property. And you know what they say, when you step through the door and it feels like home? Well, for our couple, they certainly got that feeling.
So, for a staggering £75,000 under budget, this updated character cottage offers Kate and Chris the two bedrooms they need and potential to extend in the future. It's close to Bridport town centre and less than a 10-minute drive to the sea.
The way it's decorated, the furniture, the kitchen, everything is almost to our taste, really, down to the paint on the walls, probably.
And the real highlight for me with this place would be proximity to the beach. You know, it's always been a dream that we would be able to walk Dolly on the beach, and actually here, it's completely feasible that we could do that. So that's a really big thing to think about.
Well, that was successful.
It was.
You look very at home. All I need is my camera. But that's it. So let's hit the road, shall we?
Definitely.
It's the second day of our search with Chris and Kate, who, with a budget of £350,000, are looking to swap their four-bedroom semi in Reigate, Surrey, for a character home down in Dorset. With Chris's new job starting in just 6 weeks, there's no time to lose. Still to come, it looks like our mystery house might be working its magic.
I'm a little bit emotional.
Are you?
A little bit.
And I'll be reaching new heights on the Isle of Portland.
Run all your weight through that leg, go on, push, push, push.
My heart, Will, is racing. With Chris starting a new job in literally a matter of weeks, both he and Kate are after a new life as well as a new home. And I think yesterday's house hunt was pretty successful. Today, it's all about our mystery property. Now, this house is going to offer them over 1,000 years of history and potentially everything they want. So, where's the catch? Well, I'm going to be using every penny of their budget. Let's see how we get on.
Our last stop is Maiden Newton, just 2 miles down the road from where our search began. The large village lies on the confluence of the rivers Frome and Hook, surrounded by the chalk hills of the Dorset Downs. The village centre, marked by the remains of a 15th century market cross, has a selection of local shops and places to eat, and is served by a train station with routes to London and Weymouth. The buildings are a mix of old and new, some dating back to the 17th century. The village church is said to have the oldest original wooden church door in England. Just a 2-minute walk around the corner, our mystery house sits on the banks of the River Frome on a rather notable site.
Now, it's not every day I can show our couples a property that is right next to a 1,000-year-old mill. Mentioned in the Doomsday Book, that is how old this whole area is. Wow. The good news is, your property isn't 1,000 years old. It's only about 100 years old.
I'm in love.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah. Lovely. Ready for the mystery tour? Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah, happy, Chris?
Yes.
This impressive three-storey terrace building is the largest property we've seen so far. The current owners have spent 18 months renovating the house, as well as restoring the neighbouring mill to its former glory.
Coming out of the rain, leave our umbrellas behind.
Crikey.
You've got your kitchen here, you've got your wood burner, which we've got to get out of the way, haven't we, for Chris?
Yeah.
OK. Dining area. And then we've got our sitting room too.
It's lovely. It's really nice. I love the floor, the tiles on the floor. I love the open plan living. I think that really works for kind of our lifestyle.
Fantastic kitchen.
It is grade two listed, but by association because of the old mill, because that has so much history and heritage. We all love downstairs. Let's see what we make of the next floor.
Just off the open-plan dining area is a useful utility room with downstairs toilet, completing the accommodation on the ground floor. This being our mystery house, it does have a slightly unconventional layout. There's a further sitting room and a bathroom on the first floor, which is where we're heading next.
Right, pleasing start to our house tour. I'm feeling confident on the next floor. I love the look.
I'm a little bit emotional.
Are you?
A little bit. This is like everything we would ever want.
You're making me go now. That's not the whole point. I'm meant to be taking you around. You know, could you see yourselves living somewhere like this?
May already be seeing yourselves.
Yeah, our wildest dreams, I think, yeah.
OK. I'm going to take you upstairs and show you what else there is. Are you ready for this?
Yep.
Can we improve on that reaction upstairs? You've got some work to do, right? Let's see.
I'm not sure this viewing could get any better, at least not where Kate is concerned. Also on the first floor is the family bathroom. Heading up to the top floor, there's an additional shower room and three sizeable bedrooms, all with gorgeous exposed beams and high vaulted ceilings. I'm confident we won't have any ceiling-related problems with 6 foot six Chris here.
So, on our second floor now, we can't just do, you know, the normal layout, can we?
This is a fantastic size room, absolutely enormous.
There's a great feeling of space through the whole house, even just coming up the stairs and the landings.
Love the beams.
Chris likes the high ceilings, I'm guessing.
Yeah, no, my head is not going to be bashing those in a hurry.
Now, the weather is a little inclement, but I think it is worth going outside just to have a look at that garden and that outside space.
Yes, yes, please.
Right, we'll head back. Thank you.
Back on the ground floor, there's a garage to the front of the property offering a fantastic double-height space. Then there's a generous lawned back garden.
Right. We can cheat a little bit out here. Because if you don't want to, we don't need to go out in the rain. We can stand under this canopy and see the full effect of your garden.
There's a few things I've always wanted in a dream house. One is a door in the middle, which this has. The other is a walled garden.
It's like we knew. So we're going to have to now try and put a final price on our mystery house.
It's got to be 350 plus.
I think, I'm really hoping not, but I think it might be slightly over our budget and you're pushing us a wee bit. So I'm going to say 375.
OK, well, the asking price is for offers over £350,000.
You just save
really more. See it.
They are looking for offers just over. But I think it's down to your negotiation skills.
Yeah. This could be the perfect home.
Yes. Why don't you go and have another look and decide if it is? Because it is a lot of money, I do appreciate that. And, well, I'm going to join you because I'm not staying out here in the rain, however beautiful this garden is. Off you go.
Thank you.
Taking their budget to the limit, this fantastic character property satisfies everything on Kate and Chris's wish list and more. There's an extra bedroom that Kate could use for a writing room. The living space is practical and modern, but with period features. And there's a private enclosed garden, all within walking distance to the village centre.
From outside, it looked fantastic already. But as you come through the door and just open out into this fantastic open plan living space, yeah, I think we both really kind of got that feeling.
I got a bit emotional when we came upstairs, and I think that's because this is sort of the house that you always dream that you might have, and I'm not sure that I thought that that was something that would be achievable on our budget. I think we would do anything we could to probably buy this house.
Well, I think we finished our tour of Dorset on a high with our mystery house.
Definitely.
Very successful. What are you going to do next, I wonder? Let's make a move. Chris, you grab the door. We're going to duck this way and let's go.
The Isle of Portland has long been renowned for its durable and hardy limestone bedrock, used for building across the UK and abroad for centuries. But in recent years, it's also become popular in the world of outdoor pursuits. Today, Portland is known as one of the UK's top spots for rock climbing. With 4 miles of almost unbroken cliffs, there are over 1,000 climbing routes to choose from. And with breathtaking views of the English Channel, it's the perfect location to don a harness for a lesson from local climbing instructor Will Moy.
Will, this is truly remarkable spot here. I mean, that rock face is something else.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Tell me about the geology of it.
So this is Portland stone, and so it's a sedimentary rock which has been formed by layers and layers of tiny crustaceans over a long period of time. It's been squeezed together, and now it's been pushed up and created this island and left this amazing rock for us to climb on.
It is. Amazing is a good word for it, because just standing here, you can see just so many layers. Is that why it's been compressed?
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. So that's why it's really great for us to rock climb on. It means that we've got lots of handholds to climb on, all right, and lots of little edges to put our feet on.
So who could actually attempt to climb a rock face of that sort of size and stature, if you like?
Well, that's the great thing about Portland, really. There's a grade for everybody. So starting from really young, so maybe like 5, 6, 7 years old, all the way up to, you know, 70s and 80s can get up there if they're, you know, if they're fit and willing.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm nervous, but I'm looking forward to it.
Great. We'll give it a good go.
Thank you.
The seam of limestone I'm going to be climbing is around 50 foot high. It sounds daunting, but Will assures me it's a good distance for a beginner like myself.
So, we've got the harness on.
Yep.
Got helmet's on. Helmet's on. What next?
So, this is the rope here that you're going to be climbing on. Yep. And the rope's here just to safeguard you. So, the idea is we need to tie you in. Right. All right. So, I'm going to be controlling this end of the rope.
Yep.
So, as you climb up, my job is to take the rope in. All right, so it's always there, ready to catch you.
Well, I know I'm in good hands, Will. It looks an awful way, a long way up.
Okay, so the idea, obviously, you've got lots of handholds and footholds to place your hands on. Sometimes it's quite difficult to find your way, so you do have to feel around sometimes to find the best place.
Yeah.
So the first tricky move is getting your feet up onto this one and then across to here.
Okay.
All right, and you've got an excellent handhold up here. All right, so as soon as you can get your hand up to here, the better.
Okay, so this is where my first foot goes.
Yep. And you reach right up. That's it, bend your knee a bit that way. Perfect.
Right.
Climbing is a great full body workout. Using both the upper and lower body, it works your abdominals and leg muscles, whilst all the reaching and stretching for holds improves flexibility and agility at the same time.
Will, the fact that you've got that rope is so reassuring, I can't tell you. Right, Will, next bit.
OK, so I would go out to the right a little bit. Can you see those ledges you've got?
Yeah.
Well done.
My heart, Will, is racing.
OK, so you're almost at the top now.
Yep.
So if you can climb a few more steps.
The popularity of climbing in the UK is currently on the increase. Membership with the British Mountaineering Council has more than doubled in the last 15 years.
Run all your weight through that leg, go on, push, push, push.
Well done.
I can't believe I'm practically at the top and turning around and having the confidence just to look at that spectacular view. Oh, it's worth it. Right, gotta get down now.
I can see why people get addicted to climbing. The feeling of reaching the top is just exhilarating.
And little steps down the rock now, then.
So just small steps, yeah?
Yeah, little steps.
With sport climbing on the up, it's been shortlisted for the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games.
Terra firma! Whoa! Can't believe I did it.
But when it comes to my climbing career, I think it's best I leave it to the experts and stick to house hunting.
Well, we've certainly had a very pleasant few days here in Dorset with Chris and Kate. Now, we know our couple need to move quickly. The big question is, are they going to move into one of our properties? Let's find out. Well, Chris and Kate, what a delightful few days we have spent with you driving around Dorset. It's been great, hasn't it?
It's been fantastic.
Yeah, really wonderful.
At what point do you think, as you're looking around all the properties, did you suddenly think, this is it, this could be our new home? Excuse the fireworks going off in the background.
I think it happened in possibly two of the houses. Definitely the mystery house. And possibly the cottage that we saw in Bradpole as well was something that I think we would definitely consider.
Why the mystery house? Why does that one work for the both of you?
I think just the proportions were certainly one of the things that really had that wow factor, Definitely.
That's exactly it, wow factor. I think that house had it.
So where are we going to go next?
Definitely going to do a second viewing as soon as we can. And then it's the check on the finances, a conversation with the owner, because I think we need to understand what they're looking for when it says in excess of.
Yeah.
And then, you know, take it from there.
This is all sounding really promising.
I think in our entire lives, I think it's probably the nicest house we've ever walked around.
I can so see you two in that property. You just seem to fit. You really do. It's been our pleasure. Thank you. And, well, enjoy the rest of your lives here in Dorset.
Thank you very much. It's been brilliant fun.
Thank you.
Well, I've loved showing Chris and Kate around Dorset. Such a different collection of homes, and only one of them at the top of their budget. That house, our mystery property, well, it certainly brought tears to Kate's eyes. Hearing those reactions and seeing that emotion, I'm feeling quietly confident. So that's it from, well, at least a rather rainy Dorset today, and I'll see you again in another part of the country soon.
If you would like to escape to the country in England, Wales, Northern Ireland or Scotland and need our help, you can apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.